Dad, you're gonna freak out. Guess who I met last night? I totally stalked him. The kid from Step Brothers that sings, ha, 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 ha. You know, in the back of the car, they sing Sweet Child of Mine.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
The girl's like, get it, Larry. She got a smile. You know? So I met him last night. I stalked him. I felt really weird because he was like nine.
What is he, like nine? Yeah, I was
He's like nine, and I was like. Welcome to Movie Phones Unscripted. I'm Miley Cyrus, I'm here with my dad Billy Ray and my best friend Emily Osment, and we're here at the AOL Studios to talk about Hannah Montana the movie. I'm going to sing for you guys just a little bit later, but first, we have some of your questions and we also have some of our own. So let's get started.
Okay.
Your character Lily does a lot of back handsprings and flips. Do you do your own stunts? You do your own stunts.
I do, yeah. Oh my gosh, after last week, last week we had a episode where God, it was crazy. I fell off the back of the couch.
Yeah.
I was hit by a surfboard and I fell over.
Frisbee, right? Too?
A frisbee. I was hit by a frisbee. Like, I don't know. They love to make me do stuff. But I can't do, like, back handsprings. I can do, like.
You've seen me do my back handspring.
You're good at back handsprings. I can do, like, round offs and, like.
You did that cartwheel scene where you did, like, a lot of cartwheels.
Yeah, that thing. And for the movie, I trained with Andy McDonald. So I got to, I learned how to, like, do fakies and that kind of thing, so that was really cool. He's such a cool guy. What was your favorite part of filming in your home state of Tennessee?
For me, getting back home and seeing my horses and going across the land and sitting in the shade a little bit and seeing some wild deer and wild turkeys and just being home, you know, and getting back to where the music comes from. For me, you know, I'm a singer and a songwriter, and I have a real passion for, you know, going back to where I'm from. My dad always said,
and you're talking about wild turkeys. That pretty much proves it.
But my dad always said, it's important in life to, you know, be aware of your present surroundings and aware of where you're at. And it's always important to be looking forward and knowing where you want to go in life. But most importantly, always remember where you come from.
I think I've heard you say that before. Yeah.
I say it in every interview.
No, I like that.
Oh, gosh.
You're going to make up your own question.
You're going to make up your own question. This is fun. This is like a card game.
Actually, it says Miley to Billy Ray.
Oh, dang
that
it.
Means you make up the question.
Okay, that's you, hon.
Okay, Miley to Billy Ray.
Think of a good one.
Maybe you want to ask something about the new album?
No, not something about your new album. Dad, what is your favorite part of working with me?
Oh, man, when they say the day's over.
But then you have to go home to me.
Right. No, my favorite part of working with you, honestly.
Is getting to see my face every morning.
You know, just to see you grow and evolve as a human being.
It's turning into Barbara Walters, everyone. Relax, get out your tissues.
As an actress, you know, I mean, I've seen you since the early days of you coming out on stage with, you know, Carl Perkins and you know, a lot of great acts throughout the years where you would come out and sing and do that, and then you started doing those appearances on Doc.
That's my dad's show, everyone, just in case you didn't.
Yeah, and that was my first series, was called Doc, and Miley started acting on Doc. And for me, as a daddy, to watch you evolve as not only a young lady, but as an actress, to me, that's like the coolest part. I got to go through this with you. And when I'm dead and gone, I'll always look back on this and say, good times.
Oh, good
times. Except I'll be dead and gone. What is one thing you learned about Miley while filming the movie?
I can't tell you too much at once because you get a little, like,
I get a little crazy.
Like, I have to slowly, like, ease you into all, like, if I'm just, I don't know, if I'm telling a joke because you're like, hey, that chair's black.
You gotta give me a second.
I'll make sure I'm, like,
I'm very observant.
You are, and that's a great thing.
I'm very observant, except when people are speaking to me because, you know, I have the meow meow song.
All the time.
Meow, 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 in my head.
So. Yeah. If you didn't play Miley's dad on screen, who would you cast for the role?
I think Harrison Ford would be a good dad for Miley.
I'd be okay with that.
That's a very legit answer, Dad.
I know. Yeah. That's cool. I wouldn't have been able to
Somebody. They should do something together sometime. I think you guys would be great together.
Bring me.
I'd pick, like, you know, like Dwayne Johnson, you know, because we have similar body types. I mean, we're
Well, that'd be cool,
we're so muscular.
That would be cool. He'd be a good dad for
you. Oh, he just cracked.
Wait.
Oh, I got it too.
Ooh.
Man. Oh, that's a good one. No, stop. Ew. What'd you have for breakfast this morning?
I haven't eaten breakfast. Oh, yes, I did. Yes, I did.
Because it's always interesting.
I had Doritos.
See?
Sun chips.
See?
There was pretzels and then Cheetos. Wait, did
it's
I say
Cheetos? Always something. Yeah, the other day it was like Sunchips, Skittles yeah. or something. Oh, no, yeah, you don't eat Skittles. Skittles.
I had that chocolate chip muffin. Yeah, you know what? Breakfast is the one time that you can just have something really gross because you're just like.
Because you have the rest of the day to just burn it off.
Yeah, burn it off.
Yeah.
That was awesome. Exactly. Yeah, I ate some chips.
Good.
Do not look at me as a role model for food because I'm a bad eater.
If you could hang out with any person in history, who would it be? Thomas Edison.
No, because I feel like I know him because you quote him so much.
Okay.
This is random, but I would want to hang out with Famous Amos, the cookie maker.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Have you ever read his story?
We could stuff our faces.
Don't close your eyes. He is an interesting man. He moved away from his... he's good. And those cookies, ballin'.
Just think of that. Just sitting there with Famous Amos eating your face off.
Yeah, just stuffing your pie hole or your cookie hole. It sounds like fun, right? Just chilling with Famous Amos.
Mm-hmm.
You've ever read the back of the cookie bag while you're sitting
can't
there eating?
Say I have.
Because then you can't, like, can't you don't notice how much you're eating. You're just reading
but
the back
I guarantee
of the bag.
You, Famous Amos studied Thomas Edison.
I guarantee you, Thomas Edison had nothing to do with chocolate chip cookies.
But Famous Amos.
Famous Amos.
Go to the next one. Hold on. Sorry.
I have to lose.
Crystal. In Smithfield, North Carolina. If you and Molly, Emily, are you listening?
I'm listening. Okay. Oh, right. This is a good question because we've already done it.
That's for Emily.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Crystal in Smithfield, North Carolina. If you and Molly did a duet, what song would you choose?
The other night we did a duet. We did Imagine.
Yeah, we did Imagine.
Yeah, in her studio. We just sort of did it.
I did a sweet track and we did like the drums.
I know.
And some synths. Stuff.
Yeah, it was fun.
I'd like to hear that.
Yeah.
How'd it turn out?
It's not, I don't think it's done yet.
I have it in my car.
You have it in your car? Okay, I'll listen.
Yeah, I'll listen to it. I'll listen to it today.
It's fun.
But it's not that I updated it a little bit.
It was like 2 a.m. and we were
bored.
Let's put a piece of it up in the show.
Let's go ask John Lennon. No.
Yeah, let's go. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Johnny?
What artist or band would people be surprised to learn that you love?
I was surprised
you actually like when you said you like Nirvana the other day. I didn't
know.
Oh,
yeah. Well, yeah, my little sister is more of a Nirvana fan than I am.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah,
I can totally
she's
see
nine.
That.
She loves them. Favorite thing, it smells like Teen Spirit.
Oh,
it's like her favorite thing in the world. No, I like Nirvana, but I think people like, I don't necessarily think the music that you produce has to be the music that you like, the music that you listen to. Like, I like singing pop music. I just do. I like dancing, and I like, you know, I love to act and sing and dance. So you can't really dance a lot to rock and roll.
Yeah.
You know, you can move, but it's not dancing, and I like doing pop music. But, you know, like I said, I really like Radiohead a lot. We both share that.
Thank you. That's from me.
Yes, that's from you. I really love, I love the Beatles. That's from you and Justin. And I'm just like a huge like John Lennon fan. You notice
that's
that is that I was
well.
I was studying him in school this
That's
time.
Right. We watched Chapter 27.
Chapter 27.
It was very
and
sad.
I was studying him and I like rock and roll, so just because you know, that I sing pop music doesn't mean that I don't like rock and roll. I like Elvis a lot.
Yes, I know you like Elvis.
Elvis is my favorite.
Okay. Thank you, Miley, and thank you, Billy. I'm not going to say thank you, Emily, because that would be silly. But thanks to Movie Phone and to you for watching and sending your questions. Please check out the Hannah Montana the Movie, April 10th, coming out.
Yes,
to my brother's
April 10th,
birthday.
April 10th.
April 10th, go see it,
Happy
please.
Birthday, Haley.
Happy birthday, Haley, yes. And her performance.
On AOL.
On AOL.
Music Sessions.
Yeah, check it out.
I'm looking forward to that.
Woo! Good stuff.
Good stuff.
And never pound it with someone who's wearing a metal plate for a ring.
Oh my gosh, that's
I'm
cool.
not pounding
that's
it with you
it's
no more.
I like it.
Don't pound me anymore. You're just mad because you're not blinging, Daddy.
I'm mad because I'm bleeding.
I'm bleeding.